Hi folks, welcome to Cooking with Tom and Anita. Tonight we have a very special treat for you, a dish that is so delicious that we just keep cooking it over and over again. Tell them about it, Anita.
We have these wonderful prawns that Tom is going to saute in garlic and olive oil and butter.
That's bigger than the biggest fish I ever caught.
They look yummy. Then we're going to steam this organic artichoke. And then we're going to make a roasted red pepper aioli sauce. And we're going to use that sauce for the prawns as well as for the artichoke. It will be delicious.
Yeah, this is a dish that the prawns can be served as an appetizer, an hors d'oeuvre, or they can be served as the a meal. And it's just absolutely a delicious dish. So let's get going and show them.
Okay.
To start, we're going to cut this artichoke in half and put it into the pan for steaming. First, we cut off the base of the stem, and then we cut the artichoke in half, which takes a bit of strength. But look how beautiful it is when you do that. It's a beautiful thistle and with all the beautiful colors and everything.
Oh, I love that purple.
So then we put, this is a pot of hot water, will be boiled. We turn that right side up, spread a little bit of garlic powder on it. Little black pepper. And then put that on the stove to boil for approximately 1 hour. Okay folks, the next thing we do is we're going to make the roasted red pepper basil sauce, and I'm going to use my Ninja blender to blend all that. So I take the top off my Ninja blender, and then I start putting in my roasted red peppers, which have been drained and dried. My mayonnaise. The reason I dried the roasted red peppers is because I want the sauce as thick as I can get it. It makes a better dip. Okay, I put in a little sugar, a little salt, a little hot sauce, and about a half a cup of basil leaves. This will all be blended into a beautiful kind of red sauce that will have a delicious flavor. Okay, we got to get that all in, and then we throw in the juice from a half a lemon. Ah, that's good. Good lemon. Okay, folks, and then we basically put the top back on the machine. And I have to go over to the wall plug to blend it. Plug it in, and then we press it. And I'll use my squeegee here to take it down.
Let us see that beautiful color.
Yeah, I'm going to take out my little blades. And then I put that into our bowl. Oh, look at that color. Sort of a salmon colored. Fabulous looking sauce.
That is beautiful with those little green flecks from the basil.
And then to make it look good, we'll put a float a basil leaf upon it. Whoops. And that's it.
Oh, yum. That looks delicious. Now we come to these delicious looking prawns, and I am going to shell them. So what I do is I just grab a portion of the legs on one side, and then I just gently bring around, the shell around, and remove the shell and the legs. So you just get your fingernails underneath the legs on one side and then pull the shell all the way around it so you can remove all the shell and leave the tail on.
And why do you leave the tail on?
Well, we like to leave the tail on so we have something to pick them up so we can eat them.
So it's a handle.
It's a handle, it is. And it's really fun to eat them like that. You have to have your own dipping sauce, though, because otherwise you're double dipping. So most people frown upon double dipping. So I just put the shells in this bowl on the side, and I put the shrimp back in the colander. They're pretty dry at this point, but I always put a plate underneath just in case. So they sure look delicious, I gotta tell you, and I know they're gonna be wonderful sauteed in all that garlic. Okay, now it's time to slice the garlic. Tom and I really love garlic, so we like to slice it instead of mincing it really fine. So we have this garlic peeler, and this works really well. You just take the garlic, put it in there, and then roll it around, and the skin just comes right off. It's really a time saver. Even on the little smaller pieces of garlic, it works really, really well. Just kind of roll it around a little bit. Well, I probably didn't roll that one quite as much as the other ones. Anyway, there we go. So I just take it and I kind of rest the knife against my fingernail so I don't cut myself. And then I just slice away. And you get nice thin slices of garlic. And then towards the end, I just turn it around and get some smaller slices. So you have some big ones and some small ones.
Okay, we're going to start sauteing the prawns. I've got a little EVOO, extra virgin olive oil, and some butter in there. I've got a kind of a medium heat, medium-high heat, and I put in some red pepper flakes to give it a little bit of spice. And then I'll drop the prawns in. Spread them around so they all get on the heat. And cook them for about exactly 1 minute, 1 to 1.5 minutes on this side. And then I will flip them over and cook them for about the same length of time on the other. Now I'm going to put in the garlic.
I'm getting those nice aromas already.
This garlic is delicious. Okay, so we've got a little more than a half minute to go. And you don't need to touch them during the first minute. I'm just spreading the garlic so it gets on the bottom of the pan too. I put in it a little later than the prawns because it's gonna start to overcook. And I don't want it to get too bad. I like the garlic a light brown, not a heavy brown. Okay, some of them are looking pretty good.
That butter, melted butter, sure smells good.
Doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. I like that nice sizzle too.
Can you see in the pan?
Ooh,
the nice, the great pink color they're getting?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to start flipping them. Oh yeah, they're looking great. Nice little char on them.
Ooh, that's just how we like them. Now I'm smelling the garlic too.
Oh yeah. The garlic's getting brown, but that we can't help that because it's a pretty high heat. But it'll be delicious, especially with the red pepper sauce. Okay, now we're... This is a very quick process, about 2 to 3 minutes.
Hold that pan up a little bit. Oh, look at that. Beautiful shrimp.
Yeah.
Prawns.
Oh, they look delicious. Just get them down on the pan so that they cook.
And the heat diffuses on the red pepper flakes when you cook them. So.
Yeah, it isn't nearly as hot as it is as you think. It just adds a little just heat to the and flavor to what's really delicious.
Just a little bite.
Takes a little bite. Okay, I think those are about done, so I'm going to turn the heat off. This one here looks pretty well done. Kind of a hands-up on operation, but it doesn't last very long, so you know these are going to be absolutely delicious, and I will attempt to get the garlic out too.
I know all those little bits and pieces that are left in the pot are just wonderful.
Oh yeah, look at that. All that nice brown garlic, and it didn't overcook. It's just a little bit browner than the chefs like to serve it. That's basically, that's the shrimp, and that will be plated with the artichokes, and we'll dip them in the red pepper sauce.
Yum. All right, now... For the finale, we're going to do the plating. The artichokes are done. They've been cooking about 45 minutes, maybe 50 minutes. You need to test them, though, to make sure that they're done. Just pull one of the leaves out, let it cool a little bit, and then test to make sure that it's just perfect. And so now we have these all these delicious shrimp, and I've taken the garlic that was... in the pan, and I've made sure that every shrimp has at least one garlic on it. And what I like to do, because I'm an artist, I like to make sure that the plate is really well designed and well put together. So we've got, whoops, that one flipped over. We've got 7 shrimp for each plate. And a little bit of garlic for each plate. And it all looks toasty and delicious. When the shrimp cook, they kind of curl a little bit different. So you just kind of have to look at them and make sure that they fit where they're going.
Yeah, just kind of tilt that towards us.
All right.
Oh, that looks absolutely gorgeous.